गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, आई एम प्रोफेसर दर्शना मोरे, केकेवा कॉलेज ऑफ हॉर्टिकल्चर, नासिक। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट कल्टीवेशन ऑफ कॉफ़ी। कॉफ़ी, देर आर टू मेन स्पेसिस ऑफ कॉफ़ी मोस्टली कल्टिवेटेड इन दैट वन। फर्स्ट इज कॉफ़ी अरेबिका, हैविंग द क्रोमोजोम नंबर इज 2N=44। It is tetraploid species and self-pollinated nearly 80% of the world coffee. Second one species is coffee robusta, coffee canephora. Chromosome number 2N=22. It is diploid species, self-sterile and cross-pollinated nearly 20% of the world coffee. It is suited for the instant coffee and generally utilized for the cherry coffee. Third number of species is coffee bengalensis, tree coffee wild in Bengal, Myanmar and Sumatra, occasionally cultivated in India. Coffee family of coffee is Rubiaceae. Coffee arabica, it is originated from Ethiopia, from the place called Kaffa. The word coffee is derived from the place called Kaffa. Here it is naturally in the forest between 1400 to 1800 feet elevation, and coffee robusta, it was introduced from Indochina region at the close of 19th century for planting in the estate of lower elevation. Area and production of coffee is mostly cultivated in Brazil, then Vietnam and Colombia. This is the area and production of coffee. Then, important differences between the coffee arabica and coffee robusta. First, difference between coffee arabica and coffee robusta species is ploidy level. Coffee arabica is the tetraploid species, chromosome number 2N=44, and robusta is diploid species, 2N=22. Adaptability. For the coffee arabica required higher elevation, comparatively lower elevation for the robusta coffee. Plant stature, a small tree, shrub or bush under training. For it is the characteristics of arabica coffee, and robusta coffee it is bigger tree than the arabica. Number of days for the blossoming after the receipt of blossom shower. It's for the requirement of Arabica coffee is 9 to 10 days and Robusta is 7 days. Berries per node, 10 to 12 per node, but bigger in coffee Arabica, and 40 to 60 node per smaller in Robusta coffee. Fruit development period for the Arabica coffee required 8 to 9 months and Robusta required 10 to 11 months. Root system, small but deep root system of Arabica coffee and large but shallow root system of Robusta coffee. Pollination and fertilizer, coffee Arabica is a self-sterile and self-pollinated species, and Robusta is self-sterile and cross-pollinated species. Coffee Arabica is self-fertile and self-pollinated species. Then soil requirement of coffee. Coffee is not very specific with respect to its soil requirement. Important features of ideal soil for profitable coffee cultivation are: the depth of soil, it should be more than 75 cm, shallow or compact soil, poor root development and spread. Root develop only on upper horizons and it rarely goes deeper than 30 cm deep and permeable soil. This then 75 cm well developed tap root system and rhizosphere occupy considerable soil volume. Soil pH, slightly acidic to neutral pH is the preferred, is 4.5 to 6 and even up to the 7. Climatic requirement for soil for coffee cultivation, Coffee is more exciting in its climatic requirement than its soil requirement. First, in soil, for the coffee arabica, deep friable rich in organic matter, well-drained and slightly acidic, pH is 6 to 6.5. It's same as to arabica coffee or the robusta, same soil requirement. Then extent of slope. For coffee arabica, required gentle to moderate slope is ideal, and for the robusta, gentle slope to fairly level fields to be preferred. Then aspects northeast, then northeastern aspects are ideal, and for the robusta, northeast and northeastern aspects is ideal. Then elevation for better growth and yield, 1,000 to 1,500 meters, and for the robusta 500 to 1,000 meters. Temperature requirement, 15 to 25 degrees Celsius temperature required for the coffee arabica cultivation. It's cool and equable, and for robusta 20 to 30 degrees Celsius hot and humid climate required, temperature required for the robusta. Then relative humidity for arabica coffee 70 to 80% and 80 to 90% for robusta coffee. Annual rainfall 1,600 mm to 2,500 mm for arabica coffee and robusta 1,000 and 2,000 mm. Then blossom shower March to April, it occur in arabica, and robusta February to March. Backing of showers, April and May, arabica coffee, and robusta March to April. Extent of shade, medium to light shade depending on the elevation and aspects, and coffee robusta uniform thin shade required for cultivation of coffee arabica robusta species. Then absence of blossom showers during March April, arabica coffee absence of blossom shower, and in robusta March, month of March. Then absence of backing showers during in coffee arabica, delayed beyond 1 month after blossom showers, poor crop set. In robusta, delayed beyond 20 to 25 days after blossom rain, poor crop set. Then hailstorms injures the floral and vegetative parts, and in robusta same damage in arabica coffee. Rain on the day of blossom, partial or complete failure of the crop, and partial failure of crop. Then western southern exposure with poor soil moisture, partial or complete failure, partial crop failure. Wind exposure, both species are sensitive for wind. Rainfall for the coffee cultivation, summer when well distributed rainfall is preferred for coffee cultivation, with dry months from December to March. Summer showers important for flowering in coffee, and backing showers, coffee is shallow rooted crop and cannot exploit soil moisture from deeper hands. For good fruit development, backing shower is suggested. Then varieties of coffee, arabica coffee. Selection 1, method of crop development is S288. Has high percentage of defective beans due to the false poly embroidering. Selection 2 variety, it is a method of improvement is pedigree selection. Seed distribution of this selection was withdrawn due to high bean abnormality. Selection 3 S795, multiple crosses, released in 1945 to 1946. S288, it is the cross of S311 into K Cane's Arabica Selection 3 S-795 has least mean abnormality when compared to S-288 Selection 1. It occupies large area under coffee since it released 1945 to 1946. It is high yielding variety, 20 quintals per hectare, good cup quality, high production proportion of A grade beans. Then variety selection number 4, pure line selection, selection 5, hybridization, selection 6, interspecific hybridization followed by back crossing, S-274, coffee robusta type, cross with Cane's, coffee arabica, is equal to F1, and F1 again cross with, back cross with the Cane's variety. Then selection 7, San Roman hybrids, multiple crosses, 1953. San Roman has dwarf mutant from Costa Rica and Arabica type introduced into India in 1953. This mutant segregate into 70% of dwarf and 30% of tall plants suitable for high density planting. Then selection 8, Hybrido D. Timor, pure line selection 1968-69, spontaneous hybrids of Robusta and Arabica spotted from Timor, Iceland, and was given for cultivation from 1968-69. Then selection 9, it is hybrid, crop improvement method is hybridization. Selection 8, cross with Taffarikera, drought hardy and widely adopted plants. Then selection 9 is derived across between Ethiopian Arabica collection, Taffarikera, and Hybrido D. Timor. Selection 9 has inherited all the superior cup quality traits of Taffarikera. This variety has won the Fine Cup Award for Best Arabica at the Flavor of India Cupping Competition 2002 organized by Coffee Board of India. Selection 10, Double Cross Variety. Katura crosses other than HTT, then Katura is highly susceptible to rust. Selection 11, interspecific hybridization, coffee liberica and coffee eugenoids obtained through amphiploidy. It resembles Arabica and is resistant to leaf rust and moderately tolerant to drought. Selection 12, Kaveri or Kathimore, exploitation of natural hybrids by involving hybridization, cross between Kotura and HDT. Then planting and spacing. Coffee Arabica, plant spacing of Coffee Arabica is, for the tall varieties, plant spacing is 6 by 6 meter or 6 by 7 or 7 by 7. Then Coffee Arabica, dwarf Kaveri San Roman, 5 by 5. Then Coffee Robusta, tall S-274, old Robusta S-1R, S-2R, 10 by 10 or 12 by 12. And Coffee Robusta, C cross R, 8 by 8. And other Robusta with old Robusta and S-274, 10 by 10 or 12 by 12. Plain land square system of planting. For the slopy land, contour planting and steep slopes terrace planting are preferred for the cultivation of coffee. Then opening of pits, time March-April, immediately after the first few summer showers to give scope for withering for about a month at least 15 to 20 days. Then size of pit depending on depth and type, 45 by 45 by 45 centimeter, always leave 15 to 20 days for withering. Then planting material or selection for planting. It is propagated through seed propagation and also vegetative propagation. The seed propagation in coffee, preparation of seed, selection of berries, only ripe berries are marked from marked coffee trees for seed collection and remove the pulp to get beans. Discard floats and defective beans. Seed treatment, treat seed with fungicide and dry seed under shade. Then second one method is vegetative propagation. Cutting and grafting is followed in coffee culture propagation. Propagation by cutting, selection of shoots, selection of orthotropic vertical shoots suckers from elite trees. Age of shoot is semi-hardwood and about of 6 months old. 6 to 9 months old shoots are better for propagation. Then shade management. Beneficial effect of shade in coffee. Quality improvement. Shade trees from natural canopy and it improves the aromatic flavor properties. And improve the foliar health. Shade helps in getting glossy, elegant leaves and controls premature yellowing of leaves and defoliation and dieback. Then beneficial effect of shade is mulch effect. Leaves shade from the shade trees and act as a soil mulch, which is turned held in conserving the soil moisture and prevents soil erosion and improves the soil organic matter status. Then temperature regulation, insulation effect leading to buffering effect in a soil temperature. Winter season temperature will be warm enough and summer temperature under shade trees cool. Improved organic matter status of soil. Decomposed leafy materials improves the organic matter content of soil. There will be the minimum losses of humus under the shade, thereby improving the soil physical properties. Then disease incidence, some of the disease like Cercospora leaf spot and Colitotrichum etc. are the minimized under shade situation. The yield regulation, shaded situation prevents overbearing in any of the particular year and results in less variation, fluctuation in annual yields. Then windbreaks. Shade trees serve as a wind belts and protect from the hailstorm damage and damage due to the cold waves. Types of shade trees. Coffee require filtered sunlight. It can be provided by providing a lower canopy, temporary and upper canopy, permanent shade trees. In coffee, for the shade trees, there are two types of shades are used. First one is a temporary shade, that is lower canopy, and second one is the permanent shade for the upper canopy shade. Spacing of temporary shade trees are 6 by 8 meter, one shade for every two coffee plants. Temporary shades trees are looped periodically to maintain required light. Example, a temporary shade trees are Erythrina, Lithosperma, Dadap or Halvana. Then Grevillea robusta, Silver Oak, tree spaces nutmeg, clove, cinnamon, then space at 5 meter apart. Second one is permanent shade trees. Spacing of this tree is 12 to 14 meters. Ideal shade trees for coffee is features and aim to get the filtered light. Then training in coffee. Purpose of training is height restriction, framework, bearing wood and single stem training. And second one, there are two types of training followed in a coffee. First is single stem training and second one is multiple stem training. Single stem training suitable for under the Indian condition, and multiple stem training is practice in America and Latin American countries. Single stem training system is, it is practiced in India. Topping of growing stem, main stem. Purpose of topping or canopy or capping, to restrict the vertical growth and facilitating the lateral branching, giving increased footing areas. Second one purpose of this method is thickening of main stem. It also helps in diversion of food material to thicken the main stem and primary branches. As soon as the plant reaches a desirable height, first topping height and the growth of bush is restricted by topping or capping. The height of first tier for the tall Arabica coffee is 60 to 75, that is 2.5 feet. And remark of this, it about 9 to 12 months stage after planting. And second tier, height of this second tier is 4.50 to 5 feet. And for coffee Arabica dwarf varieties, 90 to 135, that is 3 to 4.5 feet. And for Robusta, 105 to 120 centimeter, 3 to 3.50 to 4 feet. In about 18 to 24 months stage, and second tier height is 4.50 to 5 feet. Raising of second tier, depending on the fertility of the soil and spreading of the plant, when plants attain about 4.50 to 5 feet height, that is 135 to 150 centimeter, each second tier is raised. Okay, thank you. We will see the remaining part in next videos. Thank you.